God, or we just continue to give you glory, continue to give you praise. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. Amen. Savior, you can move the mountains. Mighty name.
Jesus.
Jesus. past week is my solace, my comfort, my strength. It's Jesus Christ. Hallelujah. God is so good. Thank you, Jesus. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Lord. Hallelujah. And it's always good for us to praise the Lord.
Dreams. I'm late.
We turn it to good, Lord. You are always providing. You are always there with us. Always there providing for us. Always there to comfort us. Always there to give us more than we need, God. You are always there. And I just pray right now that all of us who are here, I pray that your Holy Spirit begin to move in our hearts, move in our minds, Lord, that we are yearning for you, that we want more of you, God. We are seeking you more. We are seeking you all the time. So I just pray, Lord, that you begin to just pour into our hearts, pour into our lives, Lord, that we don't see the pain of the world, and we don't see the struggle of our lives, but we start to see the goodness that you're providing, the goodness that you will provide, the goodness that you will regain. Lord Jesus, we just ask right now, Holy Spirit, begin to move. Be with those who aren't with us. Be with Eileen, who is recovering, Lord, her health right now. Let her recover. Let her get back to her feet. Let her be able to walk. Let her be able to move again. God, and we just pray for all those who were helping yesterday. We just pray, Holy Spirit, begin a fresh new beginning in their lives, Lord. And we just pray for everybody to be restored and replenished and be ready for this day, God. So we just thank you, Lord, for all that you're doing. And God, we just pray for all those who are on their way. Protect them, God. Protect them, Lord. Let them come safely. Let them come on time. Yes, Lord, be with every single person. Holy Spirit, we lift up your name. Hallelujah, hallelujah, hallelujah. We thank you, God. We thank you, God. First, we say it with our mouths, and then we receive it within our spirit. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Hallelujah. Hallelujah. Ishimara Shibara Idabari. Ishimara Kandere Kandere. Thank you, Lord, for let your Holy Spirit continue in this place. In Jesus' name, amen. Why don't you greet one another? Say good morning. God bless you. Jesus loves you. Thank you for being here. Praise God. Hallelujah. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. Praise your name. Praise your name. Thank you, Lord. Thank you, Jesus. I love Jesus. I love the Holy Spirit. I love being in the house of the Lord. Can you all say that? I love Jesus. I love the Holy Spirit. And I love being in the house of the Lord.
I love being in the house of the Lord.
Amen. 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 I like the spirit of agreement. You know, the power of the spirit of agreement. So let's just pray right now. God, we just thank you for all that. Have come out to help with the Dongos. This is a wonderful thing. We do this once a year. And I hope that as you're doing the work, you're doing it for the Lord, not just to make good food. Amen, amen. Well, the verse of my passage is Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. And you might have heard this a lot. It says, trust in the Lord with all your heart and lean not on your own understanding. In all your ways, submit to him, and he will make your path straight. Amen, amen. How many want that in your life? Does anybody have it in Japanese? Proverbs 3, 5 through 6. How do you say Proverbs?
Shingen.
Shingen.
Oh, Shingen.
Oh, that sounds cool.
Which chapter 3?
Shingen 3, 5 through 6. Anybody have that open in Japanese? Five through six. Go, Toro. Three.
Sancho.
Five through six.
Chapter five?
Sancho.
Three. Oh. Chapter three. Sancho. Five through six.
Five, six. 心尽くして主により頼め。自分の悟りに頼るな。あなたの行くところ、どこにおいても主を認めよ。そうすれば主はあなたの道をまっすぐにされる。
Amen. Amen. What's trust in Japanese? How does it start?
Shingyo.
Shingyo?
Ne? Nani?
Shingyo, trust.
Shindai.
Oh, shindai.
Shindai. Shindai. Shindai. Shindai. So we have to trust, we have to shindai, yasama ni shindai shindai. Shuyo, shuyo. We need to trust in shuyo. And so lean not on your own understanding. I'm going to start with the second part. Lean not on your own understanding. And that is... don't think of yourself. Jibun no koto. We're already functioning. We're born into this world to think about our own self. We're here to... This is going to counteract or flip your world upside down. We're all living to understand ourselves. We live to fulfill our dreams. We live to fulfill our desires. But this proverb is saying, don't lean on yourself, but lean on God. Lean on God. Lean on the Lord. Lean not on your own understanding. Lean not on what you know, what you recognize, what you see, but start to lean on God. This is a tremendously difficult muzukashi lesson. Don't you think this is very, very, very much describes your relationship with God? Is that you are always living for yourself. I mean, we feed ourselves, we clothe ourselves, we bathe ourselves, we buy ourselves nice things, we comb our hair, we do things for ourselves. It's just natural to be selfish, right? It's just natural to think about yourself. Well, how am I feeling this morning? I'm feeling pretty tired. I'm feeling pretty good. We're naturally leaning to ourselves. And we have these desires. We have jibun no naka ni. We have our desires. What's desires? Desires, Japanese.
Yokubo.
Minna ga yokubo ga aru ne. Yokubo ga aru tame ni we live. Yokubo wa ikiru tame, right? We live. Yokubo ga nakereba, you're not really living. Anmari ikitenai ne. But we have this desire. But it's not about, there's nothing wrong with having desire and leaning on yourself. But there's a problem when we lean on ourselves over God. And the wise person, Proverbs is saying, the wise person, this is a proverb, right? So it's a wisdom psalm. The wise person will lean on God. And this is a struggle for many people, including myself, including this week. I've been, you know, we're trying to get this Okinawa dango in place, and there's a lot of leaning on yourself and a lot of self-expectation. Who's going to work? Who's going to be there? And there's a lot of leaning and why and what, and you know, even even Steve coming in the morning, we're going, what's going on? But at the same time, it might be the Lord working. It might be the Lord working. Amen.
Amen.
It might be the Lord working, and we're just trying to do everything we have to do. Things essential to continue in this work called Okinawa Dango, but there's also a part of it where we have to give it to God. We have to lean on God. Seeking, and how do we lean on God? How do we lean on God? We choose to rest in Him. That means at the point you say, okay, enough about me. Boku no whatever, boku no desire, enough about my desire. It's time for Jesus. You make a shift. You make a switch and you start to say, it's time for the Lord. Because that's what the proverb is saying. You have to what? You have to take the action to trust in God. You have to take the action to trust in the Lord. Lord, these are two things that I ask God. This is two ways that I trust in God. Two ways that I start to trust in God. That I start to counteract myself.
How do I fight against myself? I do two things. I first ask God, what is it you want? What is it you want? So when I'm in a situation where I feel it's about me and it's about what I'm doing, I ask the Lord, what is it you want? What is it you want? Kami-sama, nani ga hoshi? Kami-sama, what do you want? What is your request? How do you say request in Japanese? Kami-sama, anata no negai wa nan desu ka? Kami-sama, anata no negai wa nan desu ka? That's where I start to say, what is it you want, God? And Holy Spirit speaks. He'll say, take it easy. Don't get upset. Let it go. God will speak to you. He'll give you an answer. Just take a moment and get that word. Or just say, okay, I'm going to wait on the Lord. I'm going to wait on the Lord. What is it you want? Kami-sama, nani ga, anata negai wa nan desu ka? That's how we start to trust in God. We ask the question, what is it you want? And then sometimes we don't know. Sometimes God doesn't say, this is what I want. This is what you need to do. You need to stop getting into sin. No, sometimes he doesn't say it, so we have to say, Lord, yesterday, forgive me, but Dongos is a pressure cooker, and I choose someone. We're all in this pressure cooker. We're Dongos ourselves. I felt like I was crying in the midst of all this chaos. I'm like, ah, where's this and that, and I'm losing my mind, and my dad's going, I don't know, and we're losing our mind. But I have to do this. I have to exercise this. Lord, let me do your will. Lord, let me do your will. The Lord's will is not for me to get upset. The Lord's will is not for me to do what I want to do. But the Lord's will is to succeed his plan. And so we have to be in a posture when we're leaning on God. We first ask him, what is it you want? Negai wa nan desu ka? Kami-sama no negai wa nan desu ka? And then number two, if God doesn't give you an answer right away, he's developing your patience. And the next question is, Lord, let me do your will. How do you say that in Japanese? Lord, let me do your will.
Anata no
mikokoro
ni
shitaku. Ni shitaku. Yaru? Yaru ne. Anata no mikokoro. Okonau. Okonau. Anata no mikokoro wa negau?
Okonau.
Okonau. Okonau. So, anata no mikokoro wa negau? See, even spiritually, that's hard to say. Even in Japanese, it's hard to say for me, which means it's hard in general, right? It's hard. Lord, what is it your will? What is it your will to be done? I want you to know, Holy Spirit is in you. Holy Spirit has answers. Holy Spirit has a way to guide you. And if you just open the door, how do you open the door to the Holy Spirit? You say, Lord, let me do your will. I don't know what tomorrow will bring. I don't know what the situation will do, but let me do your will. As soon as you start to do that, you start to lean on God. You start to lean on him a little bit more. Start to lean on the Lord. And we need to ask ourselves, Lord, what is it you want? And Lord, let me do your will. Let me do your will. Not my will, right? Jesus said, not my will be done, but your will be done. See, we don't know what that's going to bring, but we walk in faith. So this is where we start to lean on that phrase. We start to lean on the Lord. We start to trust in him. We start to trust in him the moment we say, Lord, not my negai, but what is your negai? Lord, not my will, but what is your will. Arayaraba, you're going to start to walk with God. See, we have to do this. We have to do this. We can't just say, God, you're going to do it. But we have to have faith. Shinko ga nai to dame ne. Shinko ga nakereba arukenai. That's what this Mikotoba is saying. Shinko ga nakereba. If you don't trust in God, if you don't have trust in God, you will not be able to walk with the Lord. Amen. Amen. I mean, this kind of, how many understand? If you don't have trust in the Lord, you will not walk with the Lord. If you do not have trust in the Lord, you will not walk with the Lord. Okay? If you do not trust in the Lord, you will not walk with the Lord. If you do not love her or him, you will not, you will not be able to live with them. Right? All you married people. You know, so the same way with God, we have this response. How do we respond? People may ask, how is your relationship with God? How do you know you have a relationship with God? You say it's through faith. It's through faith. Faith is believing you can without evidence or proof. Did you know that's the word for faith? You have faith the moment you just believe. There's no reason or wonder or a statement of evidence that proves it. You just believe. You just believe. So instead of fear or doubt, you know, sometimes we have fear or doubt. Oh, before a speech or before something task we have to do. Maybe it's doing dango stuff too. And you're feeling worried. You're feeling a little bit self-dependent. You got to say, no, I'm just going to believe. I'm going to trust. Even if I don't see the evidence, even if I don't see the facts, I will believe that this is going to work out. I will believe. I will trust in God. I will believe. I will trust in God. Need to have faith. We need to have faith. That's how we lean on God. We have faith in God. It doesn't have to have evidence. There's no factual evidence to say you that God does and is and all these statements, but you just believe. You just trust. You just trust. You just trust. Do you ever say somebody, okay, go, like we have these things here. Go get the milk. Go get the eggs. Stir the eggs. Do you ever say, how are you going to do it? Do you ever say, how are you going to do it? Do you ever do that? Like we have all these tasks to do today. Can you stir the eggs? Can you cook the dongos? Can you do all these things? Do you ever ask how you do it? Do you ever say, well, how are you going to do it? How are you going to do that? You see, but that's evident. Well, I have to stir, I have to crack the eggs, and then once I crack the eggs and I put the vanilla in and I do that and I mix it together, that's how I'm going to do it. See, that's fear, that's doubt. When we say, how are you going to do it? But instead, we say, okay, you do it. And we have faith in you, we have trust in you that you'll do it. We don't ask for evidence, we don't ask for proof. Well, show me the proof. Show me how you're going to do it. No, we take it in faith. The same way with God. The moment you have faith, the moment you have faith is the moment you say, I don't need God to prove anything to me. That's when you have faith. I don't need proof. I don't need proof. God is going to guide us through this. I don't need proof to show me. Fear, because fear is the exact opposite. Fear is believing that you can't and you won't. Doubt and fear is you can't and you won't. Doubt and fear is, I can't, I'll never do this, I'll never accomplish, I'll never be able to be successful, I'll never make it through this time in my life, God will never provide for me. That's fear, that's doubt. But the powerful thing is we have hope in God, we have trust in God. Even the Proverbs is saying, trust in the Lord, and whatever fear you have, should turn into trust. Amen. Amen. Isn't that powerful? Whatever fear you have, how do you say fear?
Sore.
Osore. Whatever osore you have.
Kyofu.
Kyofu. Whatever. Man, that doesn't sound so scary. But whatever fear you have, whatever problem you have, whatever osore you have, the moment you start to trust in God, that fear is going to start to diminish. It's going to get smaller. I'm not saying it's going away, but it's going to get smaller.
And the moment it gets smaller is you take the next step to believe.
You have to take the next step to trust in God. Trusting in God is believing. Fear is believing that you can't, you won't. And you can't. And you gotta get actual full trust. Actual full trust is saying, I can't do this on my own. How many people have been there? I can't do this on my own. You're just overwhelmed. That puts you in a place that you're aware that if I can't do this, God can. If I can't do this, God can. That's where I want you to get to, right? Whatever circumstance, whatever situation, even little things. I can't speak in front of all these people. I can't get in front of this place. I'm not fit for this situation. As soon as you get that, flip it around. Flip it around and say, but I can't do it, but God can do it, right? It says in Philippians 4:13. What does it say in Philippians 4:13?
Do all things.
I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. I can do all things through Christ who strengthens me. So in the time of our weakest, in the time of our need, is the perfect place for God. Right? 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 Sometimes people choose not God, but they choose other things or they choose other people. They say, well, I can't do it, so I'm going to run away. I can't do it, so I'm going to get more afraid. I can't do it, it's impossible, so I'm going to get more stressed. I can't do it, so I'm going to get upset. I can't do it, so, you know, we have a response. But we have to grow in our relationship with God to the point that we can say, I can't do it, but with God, I can. Can we say that?
With God, I can.
I can't do it, but with God, I can.
Can't do it, but with God, I can.
I can, but with God, I can. 自分でできないけど神様でできる. That's the idea we need to have. A faith that we need to have, as soon as you get it, just say it. As soon as you get to the place where you're under attack, where you're under oppression, say, God, you're going to get me out of this. God, you're going to bring a new. You know, we've been praying about this time. I'll talk about people. You need people to do this ministry. You need people to do this dhammas. This has been a mission, but God is good. We prayed about it. God gave us great weather yesterday.
Amen.
And today. You see how cloudy it is? This is actually the first 2 days. I'm like, praise God, no sun. Did you know 3 days ago it was like 100 degrees?
Yeah.
And today and yesterday it was cloudy. Do you understand how valuable that is, the temperature to be this cool? It is such a blessing. You don't know how hot it is to be in front of 300. Actually, you do know. Actually, you do know what it's like to be in front of a 300-degree stove pot with hot, steaming air. God has given us 2 days of cool air. That's how we're going to overcome, okay? And then yesterday, Steve comes at 7 a.m.
Wow.
6 a.m.
6 a.m. says, I want to help with dongos. That got my dad started. See, even he's going to correct me. So, either way, we got that, and then we got... And he changed the weather for us, and he did all this weather change. See, he's doing it. I didn't ask. I prayed. But these are things God's saying, I'll give you an opportunity to do this. I'll give you a chance to do this well. And that's the thing we got to believe. Even if it's impossible, if we're saying, who's going to come? Who's going to come and help? Who's going to come and do this thing? But God has thankfully provided people. And if you have helped in this moment and in this time, give all glory to God, because you're going to get blessed. Give all glory to God, because this is how ministry is. When you can give to the Lord. So I want to encourage you, when there's fear, when there's doubt, like this situation today, we're having all faith. And how much we can sell and how much we can make. We're having all faith. Praise the Lord. Tucson's here. I know a couple years ago, you weren't even here, and that was rough, but you're here. So we give thanks to God for that too. Everything we're giving thanks to God. There's ways that He's allowing us to overcome these next two days. Amen. Amen. How to lean not on your own understanding. You have to build your faith and give to Him. You have to build your faith. How many know you got to build your faith? How many know what that means? Build your faith. You got to build your faith. That means every day you got to put in to God. Every day you got to put in like an investment. You got to put into God. Every little penny you put into God, that pennies will turn into dollars, and those dollars will turn into $100. You got to put in every day a little penny. You got to put in every day, water those plants. You got to put into God every day. You got to build. You have to build your faith. You have to build your faith. Put your requests, your desires. Yeah. I remember I used to dance in front of my mirror. I used to do these dance. I would dance so much. I just do it to the point where I didn't even remember it. That's the whole point. We got to be building our faith in God. We got to continue to put our requests to the Lord. And I notice if we don't do that, like I've been having trouble this week to do, if I don't put my trust in the Lord, stuff of myself comes out. Stuff of myself comes out. And so we need to give to God all the time. You know you're not having enough time with God when you start getting worried, when you start getting down, when you start getting upset. Did you know that? The moment you start knowing you're not spending time with God is when you start going the other way. You start losing your hope, you start getting doubtful, and you start getting out of it. So you need to build your faith, continue to replenish your faith. It says in Romans 12:12. Anybody have that in Japanese? Romans 12:12. Romashō 12:12. Juni. Anybody have that? Even Chinese. You got in Chinese, Chusan? Romans 12:12. Amen, amen. Oinori ni hage. What's that? Is that right? Did I say it right?
Hug him is bald.
Oh, yes, pray until you get bald. Pray until you get bald. Yes, that's the idea. No, I'm kidding. Hopefully I don't pray that. But the whole point is pray faithfully. Pray under affliction. Pray joyfully in hope. Be patient in affliction. Wow, these are powerful phrases. Be joyful in hope. Patient in affliction. If you're going through affliction right now, if you're going through trial right now, be patient in affliction, but also be faithful in prayer. Be faithful in prayer. You know, you may be poor in a lot of ways. You may be poor in a lot of ways. You may be poor in a lot of ways. You may be financially poor. You may be spiritually poor. You may be financially poor, you may be family poor, relationally poor. You could have so many reasons to be poor, but you are never spiritually poor. You are never spiritually poor. You are never spiritually poor. Choose on, you have it in Chinese, Romans 12:12.
在指望中要喜乐.
Yeah.
喜乐 means happy. 在患难中要忍耐.
Yeah, there you go. Yeah.
Keep in prayer.
祷告.
祷告.
Dude, I can't pray. Wow, pray. That is important. We need to be in prayer. We need to be praying. We need to be patient. It says three things. Be joyful in hope. See, we can't be, it's hard to be joyful in hope. Keep on. We got to be joyful in hope. Okay, today I'm alive. Yeah, yokatta. Now you got to have desire. You got to have Be patient in affliction. When affliction comes your way, when problems come your way, don't get mad. Don't get upset. This is hard work for me. Don't get it, everything in a bundle. But say, I'm going to be patient. I'm going to hold my temper. I'm going to hold my action. Before I get sad, before I get mad, before I act out, before I do something I don't want to do, I'm going to be patient. I'm going to keep my joy. I'm going to be patient in affliction. And I'm going to be faithful in prayer. I'm going to be faithful in prayer. These are three things that will sustain you with God. These are three things that will sustain you in your life. And you got to hold to it. Even if it's hard, hold to this. That's what it means. Patient in affliction. That means you hold to it. Even if you don't feel like it, it's not right, it don't feel right, you hold to it. And you be faithful in prayer. You be prayerful. You be prayerful. Whatever request you get, you be prayerful. You want to know how to endure things. People don't just say, well, people do say this, something, God just does it for me. God just is good for me. But, you know, behind those statements is a person who's praying in times that are very difficult. You know, it's hard to pray when you're having a tough time. It's hard to go to God when you're having a tough time. It's like taking over you, your life, everything in your circumstance, everything can take over you. But the strength is you're never poor spiritually. You're right? You're never poor spiritually. You're always going to go to God. God doesn't say, hey, give me $5 and then I'll answer your prayer. God doesn't say, give me this and I'll do this. No, actually, He will always give to you if you continue to go to Him. You got to be faithful in prayer. God doesn't just answer your prayer the first time. He doesn't just answer your prayer the second time. He doesn't just answer your prayer the third time. But He answers your prayer through your faithfulness all the time. If you go all the time, path straight. If you lean on God, He will make your path straight. If you don't get upset, if you don't get angry, if you don't lose your temper, if you don't, whatever action you could take, you don't do it, He will guide your path straight. Some people who are in the prisons, some teenagers, juveniles, sometimes they go, oh man, before they did their actions, you know, teenagers act out on their emotions. We all act out on our emotions sometimes. And sometimes they go, man, if they could have just been patient, if they could have just stepped back a little bit and just hold their tongue. Now, sometimes you can't help it. You're going to get upset. You're going to act out. But it's what you do with that the rest of the day that matters, right? It's what you do with that the rest of the day that matters. You got to give that to the cross. You got to take that to Jesus. And you got to say, Lord, forgive me. There are many moments, you know, when you can't forgive yourself or you can't forgive a situation or you can't forgive somebody, it's going to start to corrupt your heart. It's going to start to corrupt your day. Do not go through the day without forgiveness. Forgiveness is actually very difficult. I'm just talking off the cuff. Forgiveness is so important. We have to learn to forgive each other. We have to learn to forgive one another. And we have to learn to repent to God. We have to learn to forgive ourselves. We have to learn to forgive one another. And we have to learn to repent to God. Those three things you've got to do all the time in your life. You're going to have to learn how to do that. And that's going to... Because if you don't forgive, it's going to steal your joy, it's going to take your hope, and you're going to not be able to endure affliction. You need to be able to forgive, ask for forgiveness, and repent to God. Repent to God all the time. There's no shame in repenting to God. The important thing is that you go to Him and you say, God, I'm sorry if I've done you wrong. And we need to start to lean. That's also leaning on God. We have to lean on God. Don't let your own perceptions or expectations or ideas cloud or steal your hope. Okay? Don't let your expectations or perceptions or ideas steal your hope. And that's pretty much leaning on yourself. When you lean on yourself, when you think about yourself a lot and too much, this is when you know you think about yourself too much. It starts to take away your hope. it starts to take away your joy. And this is where you have to just say, okay, I can't do this. I don't know what the future holds. But God, and this is where you start to store up in heaven. You start to store up in heaven. You start to give to the Lord. You say, God, you're going to get me through this. And live through those victories. Don't stop seeing how God is unfolding what's before Him. Keep praying into things. Keep praying. Keep preserving your faith life. Keep preserving your relationship with God. Keep praying to Him. If you don't pray to Him, you're just going to start to sink to yourself. If you don't pray to Him, if you don't have a relationship with God, even if you don't, I know some people, if they don't come to church, they start sinking back into themselves. They start getting a little bit more cranky. They start getting a little bit more upset. But it's so important for us to come here. It's so important for you to be praying, because you're going to get out of yourself and you're going to get with God. You're going to get out of yourself and you're going to get with God. You're going to get out of yourself and get with God. Okay? So this is really important. So in order to lean on God, in order to lean on God, you have to continue to pray to Him and see how He's unfolding. I hope you guys got eyes. I have a list at home that I've been writing down my prayer requests, and I've been checking it off of everything He's answered. What was the recent thing He answered for me? I had to get a medical card within a day, or within the week. God got it for me. I got it within a week. I checked it off. It's just building my hope. I told you guys 2 weeks ago, I fell in Seattle and I scraped my hand. You see my hand here? And I got the wrong parking place. They charged me twice, so I had to report that. So those two requests, when I came back, were answered. My hand was healed. 2 weeks, exactly 2 weeks from all this stuff that happened. I got double tax for my parking, and I fell and I scraped my hand. But 2 weeks later, God healed my hand and gave me my parking ticket back. Amen. Okay, I'm going to tell you, keep building. Keep building your hope. I want to see God. I want to see God move in my life. That's why I'm writing down these prayer requests. I know God is working tangibly, reality in my life if I give to God. Now you see my hand. You don't even see the wound. But if you come up close, I'll show it to you. I'll show you where it was. Okay, but that's the joy that we have. That's important to keep those in mind. Keep our hope in mind. Keep your life with God in life. Life with the Lord real. And start to do that. Start to write down your prayer requests. Start to see how they unfold. And they're not going to get answered right away. And that just means God wants you to build your patience. And that means God wants to build your hope. And that means God wants to continue to build for your life. Amen. Honor the Lord, and this is another thing. In order to lean on God, you got to honor the Lord and don't sin. I know I don't really talk about this a lot, but don't sin. Honor the Lord. How you live your life, how you look at things, how you treat things is really important. Don't sin. Don't judge. Don't get in a place of sin. Idol worship. Don't get in a place of sin or lying or cheating. When you get in a place of sin, you're going to lose that honor with the Lord. You want to honor the Lord. Honor the Lord with your actions, with what you do. You know, we got a heavy rampage of homosexuality. Can I just say it on TV? We got a heavy rampage now. It's coming back. A second wave. It always comes back. You know, we got a lot of stuff in our world going on. There's a lot of sin. People want to choose sin over God. You got to live a life that honors the Lord. Say no to drugs. No to those things. No to your life. Whatever things that tempt you to do sins, turn against God, you got to say no. You got to say no. You got to live a life that honors the Lord. I'm not just saying about your spiritual life. I'm also talking about your moral life, what you do, what your right and wrongs are. Not to get upset, not to get angry at certain things, not to lose your temper. Don't let sin take over, but always honor the Lord. Live a life where you honor the Lord. It says in James 5:16, anybody have that in Japanese or Chinese? James 5:16. James 5:16.
所以你们要彼此认罪，互相祷告，使你们可以得到医治。一人所祷告的力量是有效的。
Wow, praise God, praise the Lord. I love the Holy Spirit. I love the Holy Spirit. What both you guys are saying, Japanese, Chinese, I love that. Beautiful languages. Beautiful. We need Jamaican now. No, I'm just kidding. We need Spanish too. We need a lot of the cultures here. But anyways, confess your sins to each other and pray for each other so that you may be healed. You know, if you confess your sins to the Lord, you will be healed. Sometimes we have anger, we have all these sinful things in our life, and we have to say, God, forgive me. And as soon as you say forgive me, sometimes he'll heal you of that headache, sometimes he'll heal you of that muscle cramp, whatever you're doing, he'll heal you. Okay? An earnest prayer, but this is really what I'm trying to say, an earnest prayer, a person who prays with honor, prays with humility. An earnest prayer of a righteous person has great power and produces wonderful results. Somebody who doesn't have sin, who somebody who's not seeking themselves in the time, or no sin. You know, God's very picky. If you're not living according to his policies, if you're going a different direction, if you're speaking a certain way that is not what he wants you to do, or you're talking, or you're envious, or you're jealous, or you're gossiping, whatever you may be doing, you better ask for repentance. Because he's not going to answer your prayers. He's not going to answer your prayers. You need to live a righteous life. I say, Pastor Paul, can you pray for me? Why do I say Pastor Paul? Because he's a righteous person. I see him as a spiritually righteous person. So if he can pray for me, then his prayers will get answered. Now, I'm trying to say, I excuse myself, but this is a joke. It's really a joke. Is what I'm saying. Maybe you have a righteous friend and you go, hey, you pray for me. And this usually happens. People usually ask the pastor, right? They usually ask me. I go, well, you should pray. They go, no, you're more righteous. You pray. And I go, oh, no. But the whole point is you need to live a life that's righteous. You need to live a life that honors God. You need to live a life that you're honoring God as well. You're living an upright life. And when you live an upright life, when you do what God says, when you say, God, forgive me, God, work through me, God will begin to answer your prayers. There's so many people out there who say, why doesn't God do anything for me? Check yourself. Check your sin list. Check if you're doing something that's against God. And the Holy Spirit will immediately tell you what it is. The Holy Spirit will immediately tell you what it is. You need to have a life, a righteous life of prayer. And you need to grow in your righteousness. You need to grow in that righteousness. You need to sustain that righteousness. A righteous person has great power and produces wonderful results. A person who's righteous in prayer, God's going to respond to their prayer. God's going to respond to prayer. And it's true, yeah. Ask the pastors to pray for you. I know Pastor Spain would always say, oh my gosh, everybody's asking me for prayer requests. I need their prayers too. And the whole point is, she's got a right. I always said, Pastor Spring, could you pray for me? Mom, could you pray for me? Because she's righteous. And there's so much to that. And so I hope that you're sustaining your righteousness. All your prayers that you give to God, he will respond if you're walking with him. Amen? Amen. If you're walking with him, if you're walking a righteous life without sin, not that you're perfect. You're not perfect. You're not to be prideful in your righteousness. I know some people say, I'm with God. I'm the greatest person alive. It's not that. It's not that. It's really just, look, I'm honoring God. I'm doing what he's asking. And I'm praying and he's responding. And it's true. It's true. God will respond to your prayers tremendously well when you are walking with him in a righteous manner. So always your tumi, your sin, we're not perfect. I hope you understand that. You're not perfect. You got sin, and you got to get it right with the Lord, and then he'll make your path straight. He'll make your path straight. So this is a proverb song. This is a wisdom saying that if you trust in the Lord and lean on your own understanding, what is the result? If you trust in the Lord and lean not on your own understanding, what is the result? And you submit all your ways to him, what is the result?
direct your path.
He will direct your path. He will make your path righteous. I hope that as you look back on your life, that you say, God made my path for me. You know, you can say, I made my path. This is my life. This is my goal. Don't follow what Hollywood says. Don't follow what people say. Change it to say, look, I did all these things, but I always gave to God. He always gave me a way out. He always gave me a way through, and He always provided a path for me. God will always provide you a path if you lean on Him. See, we just don't ask Him. We just don't say, Lord, what do you want? What is your desire? Remember I was saying that. I hope your next step is to trust in God. I hope as soon as you get out of these, I love this place, but as soon as you get out of this building, as soon as you get done with your prayers, kyokai wa owatte de toki and oinori wa owatta aida, after you finish, I hope you're trusting in God and not yourself. Can you do that? Can you do that? Can you step out of this building even as you're doing whatever? Today's going to be a hectic day. Even as you're doing dongos, can you step out and say, God's going to provide me to do what I'm going to do today. God's going to sustain me in what I need to do. I want you to just trust in God. The moment you step out, the moment you finish your prayer, oinori rikasuto, kyokai deru toki ni, I want you to trust in God. I want you to trust in God. I want you to finish with that. Because a lot of times people finish with a prayer, and it's like they rub God like a genie bottle and say, God, give me. God, you're going to do this. But are you really trusting? That's the difference. We're not Aladdins. We're not a bunch of Aladdins. We're actually people connected with God. And God says, the only way I communicate to my people is through how you're going to respond in faith. So it's all about us. It's all about what are we going to do. So I want you this week, I feel the Lord is saying, every time you pray, say, now it's time to trust. He said, every time I pray, now it's time to trust. Every time I pray, now it's time to trust. Amen. How many? That's cool, right? That's dope. Every time I pray, now it's time to trust. Okay? I hope you get that. I hope you get that in your life. I hope you start to live that out, because that's what leaning on the Lord is. He's going to start to lead your paths. He's going to start to guide you. And it's not going to be beautiful. It's not going to be this ideal picture. But the point is that you're in the place with God. The point is that you have God with you. And I want God to start to build your way. God doesn't just make you a path. He creates opportunity. God doesn't just make you a path. He starts to preserve your hope. God doesn't just make you a path. But He gets you there. He gets you there. He gets you there. 2 weeks. I love this. I get to choose. And it's going to take a time, but if you trust in Him, God will start to move. That's the thing about our prayers. We say our prayers only have as much life as we speak into them, but our prayers don't have enough life after we finish them. But you need to realize the life comes after you're done talking, after you're done giving your requests. You start trusting in Him. That's how real prayer works. That's how a real prayer life works. Oinori no life, oinori no inochi. Oinori no inochi ga doyatte ikute dekiru? Owari toki ni trust dekiru ne. I know I'm saying it in like English. But that's the truth. This is seisho no mikotoba de, kamisama no koto de. This is what God is saying. If you trust in me, oinori no ato de, not doubt, not fear, not jubu, but kamisama ni, you depend on God, you trust in God, you're going to get path straight. You're going to get your path straight. So I really encourage you. How many want path straight? I want you to just claim that right now. How many want your path straight? Amen. 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 You know, that's claiming. That's claiming. Claiming is the development of faith. You claim it, and then you're going to see it. You claim it, and you look for it. That's how you build your faith. You don't just pray into it, but now you claim it. Okay? You claim it. You claim it. You claim it. Amen. Praise God. Okay, okay. Well, can I pray for everybody here? Why don't we all stand? I'm going to pray for everybody here. Hallelujah, hallelujah. Thank you for this church. Thank you for Sunrise Church. Why don't you lift your hands up? Why don't you receive what the Holy Spirit has to give you? God, I just pray right now, Holy Spirit, as you're with each one of us, Lord, I pray that you begin to move. Say that, kono nakani, kono heya no nakani, anata no worship room ni, hataraite kudasai, Lord. And I just pray that whatever we're going through, every time we pray, we trust in you. We trust in you. Everything. We trust in you. We yurusu. We yurusu our desire, our whatever we're going through. It says in Proverbs 3:5-6, trust in the Lord and submit your ways to God, and he will make your path straight. So I just pray, God, that any kind of fear, any kind of doubt will be broken in the name of Jesus. Will be broken in the name of Jesus. And within every person here, within every person, that we don't live in fear or doubt, but we live in trust and hope. We live in the idea that you are going to lead us in our path straight, Lord. And I pray for everybody to have their prayer requests, to lean on God, to push forward, and to start to move, God. I also lift up this day, Lord. We have a big day today with dongos and all these things we have to do, God. I pray as we're in this moment, in this situation, that we trust in you and we acknowledge you, God. And I just pray, Lord, that you continue to fill our hearts, fill our minds and our spirits with your Holy Spirit. In Jesus' name, amen.
Amen.
Jennifer, that's very encouraging. Oh, I'm very challenged by that message. Because I've been going through a lot in my own personal life, as you know. And I need to trust in the Lord. I need to really, we say it, we understand the theology. God will make our path straight. It should be a very easy life. In other words, a very smooth life.
Amen.
Life should be smooth. Life should be easy for the Christian because we trust in the Lord. Anyway, hallelujah. So we're going to go ahead and pray for the offering. Father, we thank you, Lord, for today, for today's message, and help us to apply it, Lord. We thank you for this offering that we're going to receive. Thank you for the dongos. Dongo sales. We sold all of our dongos.
Hallelujah.
So we made over $1,500 gross. We thank you, Lord, and continue to bless us with the cool weather. And we trust in you that you're going to provide workers today.
Hallelujah.
When we go to our house, we're going to have workers to come and do and work and process and sell. And thank you for those who are here who have helped, sold very wonderfully.
Yes, God.
Made very great, deliciously.
Yes.
And continue, Lord, to bless. So, 本当に祝福してください。これから先にあなたに信頼します。
Hallelujah.
全部神様が備えてくださることを信じています。
Amen.
信頼します。
Hallelujah.
So we thank you, Lord, and bless you. This is offering we pray. この献金を今捧げますけど、この offering の献金を祝福してください。このサンライズ教会のために、伝道するために、この教会を祝福してください。一人一人も祝福してください。Thank you. And yes, キリストの名前によってお祈りをいたします。
Amen.
それから、we have いろんなお知らせがあります。We'd like to welcome Mark and Andre 無事に帰れましたこと。
Amen. Hallelujah.
You came back and that you're also helping working very hard. You're working your own work and then you're working also helping us.
Yeah, that's true. Thank you so much.
And continue to pray for Eileen Etto and just give her trust in the Lord for her life and for her complete recovery. And we thank God and praise God for the good weather, as it was mentioned earlier. And so we're going to be having lunch here, I believe, at the church. and then we'll head out to our home to begin working on everything. And we had a good report. We sold all the dongles. Every dongle we made, we sold.
Amen.
And we took probably, we had.
Yesterday, we sold 600 bags.
600 bags, yeah.
So today.
So exactly about half of what we had put together.
600 bags made 1,800 dongles.
We have enough dough for another 600 bags, I think,
each
about that much.
Three.
And a lot of work ahead of us.
But, oh, good.
Yeah, so there are a lot, I think people, it was cooler weather, people were hungry, and people wanted to eat, so they also they know about our dongles, so it was really great. Okay, amen, so I think we're going to go ahead and pray. Father, we thank you, Lord, let's up here to stand up. Father, we thank you, and we bless the name of Jesus. We magnify him, Lord, thank you for all that you're doing. And we pray today, Lord, that all that we do in the name of Jesus. Glory to God. Thank you. Bless each person, Lord. And help us to walk in faith today. Walk and take your yoke, which is easy, upon us. Not our yoke.
Yes.
Jesus is easy and light. He says, take my yoke. So we want your yoke that's perfectly fitted to our necks, Lord, to our lives.
Yes.
Thank you. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen.
Amen.
What is it, the offering? Oh.